According to an SDA official, the organization has been well respected in St. Lucia for over 100 years. The church is proud of its contribution to the development of the island, especially through its education and family life programs. It is especially proud of its End It Now campaign, which focuses on prevention of violence and abuse of women.
As a church, we do not and will not condone sin or wrongdoing in any form or fashion, whether it be from the members of the pew, to leaders, or to pastors. Following Christ's example, however, we cannot rush to judgment, and we seek to reach out to all who are hurting.
Earlier this week, two Seventh-day Adventist pastors were arrested and charged by police for indecent assault and unlawful sexual conduct. Both have been granted bail.
It is unfortunate that at this juncture that the church is now faced with allegations involving two of our employees, which has resulted in hurting families and much negative publicity. Whereas we as a church strive to uphold righteousness and purity as God's ideal, however, like all other churches, we are not immune to human imperfections and fallibility. Heaven is a perfect place, but mysteriously, sin was found in the heart of a perfect angel, Lucifer.
The SDA mission is asking that members of the public don't rush to judgment, but allow justice to take its course in the matter. Earlier this year, a government minister who is a member of the church found himself in the spotlight in relation to a nude photo blackmail scandal. For the DBS News World, I am Sheffield Gillard.